Hello everybody, my name is Jamie from Old Shipping Lines and welcome back to another video. Today we're going to talk about the life of the U-boat commander Friedrich Guggenbermer. Now this is a complete random video, it's something new. I felt like making it because I was reading it in a book of mine and I felt that his story needed to be told. So I hope you enjoy this video, so yeah, let's begin. Now of course first we're going to start with his early life. Guggenbermer was born in Munich on 6 March 1915. He had entered the Navy by 1934, transferring to the U-boat arm in October 1939, shortly after the outbreak of the Second World War. After the usual training pattern, he was assigned to U-28, where he served under the command of the Knight Cross holder Günther Kuhnke. Guggenbermer then briefly took over from Kuhnke and commanded U-28 for a few months while he was part of the school flotilla. He was awarded the Second Iron Cross. He was the Iron Cross Second Class on 23 March 1940. On that patrol, he sank two ships. Guggenbermer then received command of U-81. Commissioning her on 26 April 1941. He carried out 3 patrols in the Atlantic, encountering moderate success and sinking 2 ships. He was awarded the U-boat War Badge 1939 on 8 July and promoted to Captain Leutnant on 1 September. He was then ordered to take U-81 into the Mediterranean to join the 29th U-boat flotilla. His first attempt failed when attempting to force the Straits of Gibraltar. U-81 was spotted by RAF planes and attacked, causing heavy damage. U-81 retreated to Brest, where he was repaired. Guggenbermer was awarded the Iron Cross First Class on 9 September. He put to sea that afternoon and sank the Empire Spreekbroek. The following day, he sank Sally Mazerk. U-81 sailed again to attempt to enter the Mediterranean in November 1941, whilst transiting the Straits on 13 November. He met the ships of Force H, returning to Gibraltar. He was able to attack the aircraft carrier HMS Ark Royal, hitting her amidships with a single torpedo. The carrier was hunting U-205, which had carried out unsuccessful attack on her. Ark Royal had been turning into wind to launch aircraft when Guggenbermer struck. Now, when Guggenbermer returned to Germany after he hit the Ark Royal, it was a huge deal because he hit an aircraft carrier, which many U-boat commanders didn't do, so it was a huge deal in that time. Now we're gonna move on to his next U-boat and his capture. Guggenbermer went on to have a number of successful patrols in the Mediterranean and left U-81 on 24 December 1942, being replaced by Johann Otto Krieg. Guggenbermer was awarded the oak leaves to his Knight Cross on 8 January and oversaw the commissioning of U-847, but did not take her on any war patrols. The presentation was made on 31 January 1943 at the Wolf's Lair, Hitler's headquarters in Rastenburg, present-day Kitzingen in Poland, for the oak leaves presentation. Following the presentation, Hitler met with Dönitz and Vice Admiral Theodor Kranke in private. In his meeting, Hitler appointed Dönitz as Oberbefehlshaber der Marine, or translated in English, Commander-in-Chief of the Kriegsmarine. On 30 January 1943, on the return flight to Berlin, Dönitz informed Guggenbermer and the other officers present of his change in command. He then joined Admiral Karl Dönitz's staff for 3 months. He returned to sea in May 1943 in command of U-513. He only undertook one patrol aboard her though. After sinking four ships and damaging a fifth, she was sunk on 19 July 1943 by depth charges from an American PBM mariner, whilst off the coast of Brazil. Guckenberger was one of only seven survivors. Badly wounded, he and the others spent a day aboard a life raft before being picked up by an American ship, the USS Barnegat. Guckenberger was operated on and then hospitalized for a period before being transferred to Fort Hunt. On 25 September 1943, followed by the prisoner of war camp at Crossville later that month. By late January 1944, Guckenberger had then moved to the Pabago Park camp near Phoenix, Arizona. Guckenberger was part of the Great Pespaco Escape, a larger breakout of 25 PO prisoners of war on the night of 23 and 24 December 1944. This time, he traveled with Jürgen Kuet Vaslem and managed to make it to within 10 miles of the Mexican border before they were recaptured on 6 January 1945. After these escapades, Guckenberger was transferred to Camp Shanks, New York in February 1946, and he was repatriated to Germany. He was held in a compound in a British zone near Münster before being released in August 1946. Now, after the war, Guckenberger luckily survived. On 16 November 1940, Guckenberger married Lisiotte Fischer. The marriage produced four children. Guckenberger became an architect before rejoining the Navy, by now the Bundesmarine, in 1956. From 5 August 1958 to 25 June 1959, he studied at the Naval War College in Newport, Rhode Island, and rose to the rank of Kontradmiral. He became the Deputy Chief of Staff in the NATO command AFN North and served there for 4 years. So the commander had a good life after the war and he retired in October 1972. But sadly though, in his last years, Guckenberger suffered from Alzheimer's disease. And now this is where the story gets a little mysterious. On 13 May 1988, he left his home for a stroll in a forest, but never returned. So, what I think happened is because, of course, in Germany, in the forest there, we have quite big hills. So maybe he slipped and fell, I think. But his body was found 2 years later, so that's quite sad. So, that is the end of this vid. I hope you enjoyed the randomness of this video, of this idea. I'm planning to make more of these videos in the future, talking about maybe shipping companies or life of some officers or people on board ships. So I hope you like this idea of me. I hope you like this new idea as well. So I hope you also liked this vid. And if you have friends who like ocean liners or ships, please show them my channel. We are trying to reach 400 subs. And please also leave in the comments what you thought of this video. And leave also, of course, then a comment, because your comments help me very much. I also quickly want to thank all the new subscribers who have subscribed to my channel. It also really means a lot. And with that out of the way, we will see each other on the next video. So have a good night or day, wherever you are. And goodbye.